Hello and welcome back to my channel. For this card, I am doing a relatively flat shaker with glitter in it, and the stamp set that I used here, which I forgot to show, is the Clearly Besotted All-in-Onesie Halloween stamp set. And for my little mummy, I had W00, W2, and W3. I didn't want it to look clean, so I felt like the warm grays made it look a little bit dirtier than maybe the cool grays. I don't know. Anyway, for my next color combo, I'm using Y15, 17, 38, and YR24. This is pretty close to the colors that I usually use for my pumpkins. I don't know that I really have any other combinations that I really love for pumpkins. So, this is it. Most of this won't be seen in my card, but at this point, I didn't know what I was doing, so, like always, or nearly always, I'm just winging it. I do show you how I colored the little devil character, but I never used it in my card. For my bat, I'm using BV01, 04, and 08. And, again, the bat, I'm only doing it purple because I just felt like it was cuter than doing it black or gray. And this just added more color to my card. Now for the lighter part of the belly, I used BV000. And I also used my lightest BV color that I had for the main part of the bat body. For my little skeleton, I'm actually using blues, so B93, 95, 97, and 99. Again, the reason for this is just to add more color to the card so that it wasn't so much black and gray. For my little devil, I'm using R24, 27, 29, and 89. And again, I don't actually use this one in my final card. There are 6 characters in total, and I didn't really love that amount, and I had a hard time deciding how I would keep the layout. But I still colored it. I still have it on my desk somewhere. Now to make the horns and the wings just a little bit different, I'm using R29, 39, and 59. I don't know if this changed it enough. I was trying to just make it look more distinct so it wasn't one giant red blob. Still felt a little blobby to me here, so I pulled out my C3 marker, which is about to die, and I went over the wings and the horns. Now I'm using YG03, 5, 7, and 9 for my spider. I know this is an odd one too. Again, it's just the color thing. I think if I was just doing the spider, I probably would have done it cool grays with maybe a more red belly, like a black widow. I don't know, that was just the first thing that came to mind, but I wanted color here, so I went with yellow-green. I don't hate it. Now here's where I go in and fill in the shoes and anything I wasn't sure about. I'm using this C8 to fill in the little spider legs on the spider costume. And I'm also filling in the jack-o'-lantern face and the eyes for all of the other characters. I'm also using R20 on the nose for the bat. And I'm going to use E31, 35, and 57 for one of my skin tones. Now, I do a different skin tone and hair color for each of my characters. I just thought it would be cuter for them all to look a little bit different. For her hair, I'm doing BV08 in the C5 marker, just to make it not look so gray like she's an old lady. In these, I determined, E50, E51, and 53 for my next skin tone. I determined their gender later, so that's why I didn't color the inside of each hood yet. That way I could make it look like hair if I wanted it to be a girl character. For that hair, I'm using E23 and E25. And this is not normal for me. I usually use at least 3 color blends, but it's such a small area, there's no way you can do it. For next skin tone, I'm using E40, 41, and 42. Her hair is C3 and C5. And this one is the last little girl that I do. The rest will be boys. No real reason other than the bat looked like a girl to me, definitely. And the mummy was kind of cute as a girl. The next skin tone is E000, E00, and E21. His hair will be YR24 and 27. And as you'll notice, for the boys, I do go in with the darkest or one of the darker colors for their costume and just color in the inside of the hood. Next skin tone is E11, 13, and 15. And then for this boy's hair, I used E74 and 79. For my little spider boy, he's E13, E15, and E18. I do have some mermaids that I had colored, and there's 2 pages of mermaids. I think that's all it was. I have them on my Instagram page with the different skin tones and hair colors that I use. So if you want to go check that out, I will leave a link in the description box below. Now here I'm just using that marker and my white gel pen to darken anything, highlight anything, correct any mistakes. And I'm also going to take that same R20 marker and I am going to blush the cheeks a little. And here I'm taking a brush marker. It is a Prismacolor liner. And I am going to go around the edges of my die cut pieces. Or, I guess they're not technically die cut. They're cut pieces. Yep, fussy cut. And I'm just doing that so that the white edges don't show, especially because my background ends up being black slash kind of gray. And for my background, here it is. I ink blended it with Distress Oxide in the color Soot, Black Soot. And now I'm taking the Stardust liquid. I can't remember the name. It just was on screen. But I splattered the background just for it to be a little bit shimmery. And now I'm using YG05, BV04, and was it Y38, I believe. My stuff's going a little bit too fast. I didn't write it down. Whoops. And I'm just coloring different letters for my sentiment. This, I used my Cricut to cut out. And I was cutting this out, or coloring this, and I'm looking at it after I get the purple in there. And I'm like, why does this remind me of Cinnamon Toast Crunch? It really does. It bothered me so bad. I actually had to look it up and see what colors the Cinnamon Toast Crunch label was. And it's not exactly like this, but it is green. I think like a reddishy or, yeah, orangey red almost. At least what it looked like on my phone. Purple and blue. So if it reminds you of something, it's probably Cinnamon Toast Crunch. Oh well. I kind of got over it at some point, but it was a little disappointing slash jarring for a little while. Alright, I am using just a plain white card base, attaching my panel onto it. Now I have these thin frames that I also cut out with the Cricut, and I have several stacked here. I think it's 5 of them, and my shaker elements are going to be fairly thin, so I didn't have to have anything too thick. I just glued them flat to the card base, left a book on it for a while, came back to it, And now I'm going to attach my last frame on to my acetate that is cut to the same dimensions as my card. This was a little bit fiddly, and it took me way longer than I'd like to admit. It was worth it in the end. Once that was complete, I took my anti-static powder bag and I went over my card and the acetate with it so that my glitter pieces wouldn't stick so bad to the acetate or anything sticky on the card. And here I'm just loading it with these little glittery pieces that I have in coordinating colors. I did add some clear stars and some little black, I don't know if they were hexagons or circles, I didn't really pay that much attention. But my yellow pieces are actually, what were they, shamrocks? Something like that. I don't know. It doesn't really match as far as the shape. I tried to stick with stars. Man, I can't talk. Anyway, I'm now gluing all my pieces down onto the acetate. And for my little pumpkin girl, I wanted her behind the trick-or-treat sentiment. And then I have my little mummy and my little skeleton kind of tucked, like they're peeking out from behind the sentiment. And then my little spider and my bat are just hanging out at the sides. After that, my card is complete. I hope you guys enjoyed this quick tutorial, or I guess if you already knew how to do this, I guess I hope you enjoyed the process and my horrible commentary. I will be back with another video soon. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye!